So ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral in which one of the angles you know, that is angle ADC, is given 92 degrees. Now when you know that ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral, you should make use of the cyclic property, and making use of the cyclic property, you can easily calculate the angle ABC. Angle ABC will be equal to 180 degree minus 92 degrees, that is 88 degrees. So the next important information given is that AF is parallel to BC. Why it has been given that AF is parallel to BC? So that you can make properties of the parallel lines. Recall the properties of parallel lines. If AF is parallel to BC and AB is a transversal, then you can easily know the angle FAB, because the angle FAB and CBA are alternate interior angles. When you are having parallel lines and a transversal, then you should be able to recall the property that the alternate interior angles are equal. That means angle FAB will be 88 degrees. Now again, you can make use of the cyclic property, that is the exterior angle will be equal to the opposite interior angle. That is, if ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral, then the angle EAB will be equal to angle BCD, because this is a cyclic property. When you have been given that ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral, that means you should make use of the cyclic properties. If angle EAB is equal to angle BCD, then you must calculate the angle EAB. Angle EAF has been given 20 degree, and angle FAB you have calculated 88 degree. That means angle BCD will be equal to 88 degrees plus 20 degree. Because it has been given that I is the in center, so you must recall the property of the in center. And angle BAC 66 degree, that means the line segment AI will be the angle bisector of the interior angle at A. So you can easily write the two angles, angle BAI and CAI will be 33 degree each. Now angle ABC is given 80 degrees. We have to find the angle DBC. So now we have to calculate the angle DBC. In order to calculate the angle DBC, first we should join the points B and D so that we can see the angle DBC. Now look at the arc CD. CD is a pending angle of 33 degree at the vertex A. The angles in the same segment are equal. That is, the CD will subtend same 33 degree angle at the vertex B. In other words, angle DBC will also be 33 degree. Now we have to calculate the angle IBC. In order to calculate the angle IBC, first we should join the points I and B. As you know, the basic property of the in center, that the line segment joining the vertex with the in center will be the angle bisector. So here BI will be the angle bisector of the interior angle at B, that is angle IBC will be equal to 40 degree, and angle IBA will also be 40 degree. Now we have to calculate the angle BIC. So we should join the points I and C so that we can see clearly the angle BIC. Now here you might think that triangle BIC is an isosceles triangle where BI and IC are the radii of the larger circle. But this thinking is wrong, because I is not the center of the larger circle, but I is the center of the smaller circle. because I is the in center. So I is the center of the circle which is inscribed inside the triangle ABC. So do not think that triangle BIC is an isosceles triangle. What you can do is you can calculate the angle ACB, because in the triangle ABC two angles you know, one angle is 80 degree, another angle is 66 degree. And then after calculating the angle BCA, you know that the line segment CI will be the angle bisector. So you can calculate the angle ICB. Angle ICB will be one half of the angle BCA, that is 17 degree. Now you can take the triangle BIC. One angle is 40 degree, one angle is 17 degree. So the remaining third angle you can easily calculate. It will be 180 minus 40 minus 17. This is the correct way of doing it. So as you are reading this question, AB is equal to AD is equal to DC is equal to PB, you must get a feeling that I should make use of the properties of an isosceles triangle. And angle DBC is given X degree. So let us join the points D and B so that we can see clearly the angle DBC. So now this angle DBC is given X degree. You must think that the angles subtended in the same segment are equal. So if arc CD subtending angle of X degree at DB, then it will subtend the same X degree at the vertex A. So let me join the points A and C. Now if CD subtending X degree at B, that means angle DAC will also be X degrees. So you can write the angle DAC to be X degree. Now look at the triangle ADC, because AD is given equal to DC, that means triangle ADC is an isosceles triangle. So you can write the angle ACD, angle ACD will also be X degree. Now look at the arc AD, it is subtending angle X degree at the point C. This means angle ABD will also be X degree, because angles in the same segment are equal. Again, you can see that the triangle ADB is an isosceles triangle, because AB is equal to AD. This means that angle ADB will be equal to angle ABD, that is X degree. Now you can make use of the cyclic property. Quadrilateral ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. That means the sum of the opposite angles will be 180 degree. So we can say angle ABC plus angle ADC will be equal to 180 degree. Angle ABC, you know, X plus X, that is 2X. And angle ADC will be equal to X plus angle BDC. So from here you can calculate the angle BDC. It will be 180 minus 3x. Now angle PBA is the exterior angle. So it will be equal to the opposite interior angle. That is, angle PBA will be equal to angle ADC. You can say that angle PBA will be equal to angle ADC. That is angle ADB plus angle BDC. So here we have made use of the cyclic property. That is, angle PBA will be equal to X plus angle BDC. Substitute the value of angle BDC, 180 minus 3X. So we'll get the value of angle PBA. Angle PBA will measure 180 minus 2X. because AB is equal to PB, so triangle PAB is also an isosceles triangle. If triangle PAB is isosceles triangle, it means angle PAB is equal to angle APB. Sum of the interior angles is 180 degree. Substitute the values. APB and PAB are equal. Because we have to find APB, so instead of angle PAB, I am writing APB. Measure of angle PBA is 180 minus 2x. So from here you can easily calculate the value of angle APB. Angle APB will come out to be x degree. So now observe that the angle APB is equal to angle DBC is equal to x degree. This clearly shows that AP is parallel to DB, because angle APB and DBC are corresponding angles. If the corresponding angles are equal, it means that the line AP and DB are parallel to each other. In order to help you see more clearly, I am extending the line AP and DB so that now you can see more clearly. And here take the line PC as transversal. You will clearly see that the two angles APB and DBC are corresponding angles. If corresponding angles are equal, it shows that line AP is parallel to DB. So ABC, AEQ, CEP are straight lines. We have to prove that angle APC and CQE are supplementary. What is the meaning of straight line? A straight line means that you must have a pair of angles which add up to 180 degree. So let us join the points E and B. This means that if ABC is a straight line, then ABE and EBC will together add up to form a straight angle. So we have to prove that angle APE plus angle CQE add up to 180 degree. You should see cyclic quadrilateral PEBA because all the vertices lie on a circle. Recall the cyclic property, that is the sum of the opposite angles is 180 degree. So we can say that angle APE plus angle EBA will be 180 degree. Similarly, EQCB is a cyclic quadrilateral. So the sum of the angle EBC plus CQE will also be 180 degree. So now we are having two equations. Angle APE plus angle EBA is equal to 180 degree, and angle CQE plus angle EBC is equal to 180 degree. You can add these two equations. You will get angle APE plus angle CQE plus angle EBA plus angle EBC will be equal to 360 degree, because ABC is a straight line. Hence angle EBA plus angle EBC will be 180 degree. If you solve this equation, you will get angle APE plus angle CQE is equal to 180 degrees. As soon as you read the line that AB is the diameter with O as the center, you must recall the theorem that in a semicircle, angle subtended is 90 degree. Immediately you will get the clue that I should join the points B and D so that angle ADB can be 90 degree. Now angle ADC value is given 32 degree. So you can easily calculate the angle CDB. Angle CDB will be equal to 90 minus angle ADC, that is 90 minus 32 degree, 58 degree. Now you know that the angle subtended at the center by an arc is twice the angle subtended at the remaining part at any other part on the circumference. So look at the arc BC, it is subtending angle 58 degree at the point D on the circumference. This means that arc BC will subtend an angle 2 times of 58 degree at the center O. in a cyclic quadrilateral PQRS, angle PQR is equal to 135 degree. Side SP and RQ produce meet at point A, whereas sides PQ and SR produce meet at point B. If angle A is to angle B, ratio is equal to 2:1, find angles A and B. So an important point regarding this question is that figure is not given. Such questions are a bit difficult because you cannot easily visualize the question. So first of all, you must draw a proper figure. Take the help of a ruler. It will be easier for you. Then solve this question. So in this figure, PQRS is a cyclic quadrilateral. One angle you know, 135 degree. It has been given that the ratio of angle A is to angle B is 2:1. That means if you take angle B to be X degree, because the ratio is 2:1, that means angle A will be 2X. So I have taken here angle B to be X degree. It means that angle A will be 2X degree. Now PQRS being a cyclic quadrilateral, angle PQR plus angle PSR will be 180 degree. Using this information, we can calculate the angle PSR. Angle PSR will be 180 degree minus 135 degree, that is 45 degrees. So now we can consider the triangle ASR. Some of the interior angles will be 180 degree. That means 45 degree plus 2x plus angle QRS, that is angle ARS. Angle ARS and QRS are one and the same thing. The sum of these three angles will be 180 degree. Similarly, in the triangle PBS, we can say 45 degree plus x plus angle SPQ or SPB will be equal to 180 degree. Because PQRS is cyclic quadrilateral, that means angle QPS plus angle SRQ will be 180 degree. So using this information, you can write the value of angle QPS. Angle QPS will be 180 degree minus angle QRS. So instead of QPS, you can write 180 minus QRS. So the second equation will become 45 degree plus 180 minus angle QRS plus x is equal to 180 degree. From here you can calculate the value of QRS. Or you can simply add these two equations. Two equations you will get. And there are two unknown variables, x and angle QRS. So you can easily solve these two equations. Here I will add these two equations, because in one equation I am having plus QRS and in the other equation I am having minus angle QRS. So if I add it, angle QRS will get cancelled and only one variable is left. So from here I can easily calculate x. Equation you will get is 45 plus 3x is equal to 180 minus 45. If you take 45 on the other side, it will become 180 minus 90 divided by 3. So x will come out to be 30 degree. X is 30, it means the angle at B is 30 degree. If angle at B is 30 degree, that means that angle at A will be 2x, that is 2 times of 30 or 60 degree. So first pay attention to what information has been given in the question. AB is the diameter and O is the center, and chord CD is equal to radius AO. We have to prove that angle APB is equal to 60 degree. Now in this figure you cannot see measure of any angle. So first efforts we should make to get the measure of some angles. We can see here that chord CD is equal to radius AO. Let us join the points O with C and D so that we can see other radii also. Now if you see carefully, then triangle COD is an equilateral triangle, because CD is equal to AO. and AO is equal to OC, and OC is equal to OD, OD is equal to OB, all are radii of the same circle. So following this approach, you can conclude that triangle COD is an equilateral triangle, and if COD is equilateral triangle, you can get the measure of each of the interior angles, because in an equilateral triangle the interior angles are equal, measure of each interior angle is 60 degrees. So like this you can get measure of sum of the angles in the figure. Now we should try to deduce the other angles and then try to correlate this information with the measure of angle APB. Now see the triangle AOC. You will realize that triangle AOC is an isosceles triangle because AO and CO are the radii of same circle. That means you can express the angle COA in terms of the angle CAO. We are doing this because we know that angle CAO is same as angle PAO. So our effort is to somehow get the measure of the angle PAO and PBO. If we are able to do that, then we can easily calculate the measure of angle APB. So if triangle AOC is an isosceles triangle, we can say that 2 times angle CAO plus angle AOC will be equal to 180 degree. We will not have any trouble whatsoever in calculating angle AOC, because just like AOC is an isosceles triangle, we know that triangle OBD is also an isosceles triangle, and AOC plus COD plus BOD will be 180 degree because AB is the diameter with O as the center. So this should be the way to think while we are solving a problem. So similarly, triangle OBD is an isosceles triangle. So you can say that angle BOD plus 2 times angle OBD will be equal to 180 degree. So now you are having 2 equations. You can add them. If you add these 2 equations, you will get 2 times of angle OAC plus angle OBD plus. Now what about sum of angle COA plus angle DOB? This you have to think, and the right hand side will be 360 degree. So now OAC is same as OAP. If you write it like this, you will get an OBD is equal to OBP. So if you write it like this, you are getting 2 angles of the triangle PAB. Now COA and BOD, this will be equal to 180 minus 60, because angle COD you already know 60 degree, and AB is the diameter. That means AOC plus COD plus BOD will be 180 degree. So from here, angle COA plus angle BOD will be 120 degree. So that 120 you can write in this equation, solve it, you will get the sum of the measures of angle OAP and OBP. So the remaining third angle in triangle PAB you can easily calculate. If the sum of the measures of 2 angles is 120 degrees, then the third angle will be 60 degree. Like this you can do it. the moment you see the question and you read it, you have to prove that EF is equal to CF. So first you should join C with F so that you can see CF clearly. And then if you have to prove that EF is equal to CF, you must think that the question wants you to prove that triangle EFC is an isosceles triangle. That is, you should start thinking in terms of angles. You must prove that angle FEC is equal to angle FCE. On the other hand, AD is parallel to BE. That means angle DAE will be equal to angle AEB. These are alternate interior angles. And then instead of AEB, you can write FEC. So like this way, you have come to one angle, angle FEC of the triangle CFE. Now our effort should be to get in the other angle, which is opposite to angle FEC, that is angle ECF, and somehow prove that ECF is equal to FES, then only EF can be equal to CF. Now look at the arc BF, it is subtending angle BAF at the point A, and angles in the same segment are equal. That means angle BAF will be equal to angle BCF. And you know that AE is the angle bisector of the angle BAD. That means BAE is equal to EAD. Angle FCE is equal to angle BAF. And BAF is equal to angle EAD, and angle EAD is equal to angle AEB, and AEB is equal to angle FEC. So like this way, you can prove that angle FEC is equal to angle FCE. If angle FEC is equal to angle FCE, it means that triangle FCE is an isosceles triangle, or in other words, EF is equal to CF. In the second part of this question, we have to prove that BF is equal to DF. Now there can be multiple ways of proving. One of the simplest approach can be to look at the angles BAF and DAF. You know that the angles subtended in the same segment are equal. That is, angles subtended by the same arc will be equal. If you think in the reverse manner, that is converse of this statement, then if the angles are equal, it means that the two arcs, that is BF and DF, must be equal, then only they can subtend equal angles. If the arc BF and DF are equal, it means that the chords BF and DF must be equal, because equal arcs can only have equal chords. There can be another method also. For example, we can look at the triangles BEF and the triangles CFD. Now, you know that ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. In a cyclic quadrilateral, if one pair of sides, for example here AD and BC, are parallel, it means that the other two sides must be equal. That is, in this case, AB will be equal to CD. There is a solved example in the textbook, example number 15. You can refer that example. So here I am directly using the result. AB will be equal to CD. Now, look at the triangle ABE. You know that angle BAE is equal to angle AEB, because AE is the angle bisector, and angle BEA is equal to angle EAD. This means that triangle BAE is an isosceles triangle. So you can say that AB is equal to BE, and you also know that AB is equal to CD. That means you can directly write that in the triangles BEF and FCD, BE is equal to CD. Next, look at the angles AFB and the angle DFC, because the chords AB and CD are equal. That means the arcs AB and CD will be equal. If the arcs AB and CD are equal, they will subtend equal angles at the point F. So you can say that angle AFB will be equal to angle DFC. Angle AFB is same as angle EFB. So we can say that angle EFB will be equal to angle DFC. Now, EF is equal to CF. This we have proved earlier in the first part. And also, you can look at the angles, angle FBE and angle FDC are subtended by the same arc CF. CF is subtending an angle at B, and it is also subtending an angle at D. That means angle FBE will be equal to angle CDF. Now in these two triangles, you know that two angles and two sides are equal. That means these two triangles must be congruent. You can say by angle side angle or angle angle side. Angle angle side congruency or angle side angle congruency. When the two angles and one side of one triangle are equal to the two angles and one side of the other triangle, then we can make use of the angle angle side if the side is not included, or angle side angle if the side is included. So here you can say that by angle angle side, these two triangles will be congruent. If they are congruent, then BE is equal to CD, EF is equal to CF, and BF will be equal to DF. Like this you can do. So one important information is that ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. ABCD is cyclic quadrilateral means that you must use cyclic property while solving this question. And second important information is that the ratio of angle DCF to angle F is to angle E is equal to 3:5:4. So because ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral, let us assume that angle DCF is equal to 3x. If angle DCF is 3x, then angle F will be 5x and angle E will be 4x. Now you can make use of the cyclic property. Angle DCF is 3x. In a cyclic quadrilateral, the exterior angle is equal to the opposite interior angle. That means angle DAB will be equal to angle FCD, and angle FCD we know 3x. So we can say that angle DAB will also be 3x. Now you know that in a cyclic quadrilateral, the opposite angles form a supplementary pair. So if angle DAB is 3x, you can easily calculate the angle BCD. Angle BCD will be equal to 180 degree minus 3x. So angle DCB will be 180 minus 3x degree. Now FAB is a triangle, and you know that sum of the interior angles of a triangle is 180 degrees. So using this information, you can calculate the angle ABC. In the triangle FAB, angle FAB plus angle FBA plus angle AFB will be 180 degree. Substitute the values for FAB. FAB is 3x and FBA we have to find. Angle AFB we know 5x, so angle FBA or we can say angle ABC will be equal to 180 minus 8x. Again you can make use of the cyclic property that sum of the angle ABC plus angle CDA will be 180 degree. So you can write the value of the angle CDA, angle ADC plus angle ABC will be 180 degree. So angle ADC will be equal to 180 degree minus angle ABC. Angle ABC we have calculated 180 minus 8x degree. So angle ADC will be equal to 8x degrees. So now in the triangle AED, all the values you know. That is, all the interior angles you know. And you know that sum of the interior angles will be 180 degree. That is angle DAE plus angle ADE plus angle AED will be 180 degree. So instead of DAE, you can write 3x. Instead of ADE, you can write 8x. And instead of AED, you can write 4x. You will get an equation from which you can find the value of x. If you solve the equation, you will come to know that x is equal to 12. If you know the value of x, then you can solve all the interior angles of the quadrilateral you know in terms of x. So you can easily calculate all the interior angles of the quadrilateral ABCD. Now as soon as you read this question that PR is the diameter, first thing that should come to your mind is the theorem that angle subtended in a semicircle is 90 degree. And next it has been asked to find the perimeter. So the next important point that should strike your mind is the use of Pythagoras theorem. If these two points you are able to recall, that is the angle subtended in a semicircle is a right angle, and that I have to use a Pythagoras theorem in this question, then the question becomes very simple. You should know in a right angle triangle which side is the hypotenuse. The hypotenuse is the side which is opposite a 90 degree angle. So in the triangle PQR, you have to take PR as the hypotenuse and then use the Pythagoras theorem. Two sides you know, 7 and 6. So using Pythagoras theorem you can easily calculate PR. And then in the second triangle PRS, again you have to take PR as the hypotenuse because it is opposite the 90 degree angle. So now in the triangle PRS, once again PR will be hypotenuse because it is opposite the 90 degree angle. So using PR as the hypotenuse, you can easily calculate PS. So taking PR as hypotenuse using the Pythagoras theorem, you can easily calculate PS. And once you know PS, then you can find the perimeter easily, because perimeter is the sum of the four sides of a quadrilateral. Here PS is 9 cm. So now we can easily calculate the perimeter. Perimeter will be sum of PQ, QR, RS and PS. That is 7 plus 6 plus 2 plus 9. You will get 24 cm.